In this video, I want to talk about how and why to calibrate a pH probe. So the blue LabQuest pH probe looks something like this, and it'll come in a vial of storage solution, and the pH that you'll see when you plug it in will be about 4, maybe 3.5, maybe around 3, something like that. The pH probe is basically just an electrode, and the electrode degrades over time and gets bumped around, and so its sort of baseline voltage can shift over time. So we need to calibrate the pH probe from time to time so that we get consistent pH readings over time. So the probe kind of has no knowledge of what its pH reading should be, so we, in a sense, need to tell it what its pH reading should be. To do this, we're going to use two different buffer solutions with a set pH, a pH 7 buffer and a pH 4 buffer. When you calibrate, generally the true or known values you use should be in the range of the pHs you're going to get, and 4 to 7 is pretty close to most of the pHs we'll see in our experiments. So the first step is to unscrew the storage capsule here and take out the pH probe. I like to keep a beaker of distilled water around. It's good to catch washings that we'll use later, and I often will just store the pH probe in this distilled or deionized water. Now you'll notice right away that the pH here will not necessarily be 7, and that's to be expected because the water is deionized, and the pH electrode, which is an electrical device, depends on the presence of ions that can conduct electricity within the solution to give an accurate reading. So don't worry if this reading isn't exactly 7.00. So what we're going to do first is open the pH 4 buffer and go ahead and toss in the pH electrode. Don't worry if it's a little bit wet. In fact, it should remain wet at all times, and the little bit of water that we add in there isn't going to affect the pH because we're using a buffer, right? You should allow the pH buffer to settle for about 30 seconds. It takes a while for the voltage there to settle. So at this point, I can go to sensors, calibrate, pH. This will bring me to a screen on the LabQuest where I can enter the known or the true values. And the beauty of this approach is that we know the pH of the buffer. It maintains a pH of 4.00. So after giving some time for that electrode to settle, we can type 4.00 here for the true value. And then you may need to scroll down to see this using the scroll bar on the right-hand side, but there's a button below that text field that says keep. We can hit that, and that'll register, okay, the voltage, which here you may not be able to see this, it's 2.40 volts, that's associated with a pH reading of 4.00. And notice that that's different from the pH reading we saw before we calibrated. The next step is to move it over to the pH 7 buffer and register the true value there as pH 7.00. So I'm going to put this guy down and go ahead and type in the reading value here as 7.00. Before I transfer over the pH 7 buffer, I'm going to wash off the pH electrode back into my distilled water beaker here, and this is a wash bottle containing distilled water. Give it a few washes, maybe blot it with a paper towel to kind of dry off the distilled water a little bit, and then I'm just going to dunk it into the pH 7 buffer. Again, I'm going to give this about 30 seconds to settle, and this may be a little bit difficult to see, but the voltage reading, which is at the top of the calibration screen, is changing now. And in fact, perhaps a little bit counterintuitively, the volume reading has actually gone down. So this emphasizes the need to calibrate. There's an indirect or an inverse relationship between the voltage and the pH, so we kind of need to tell the LabQuest how this relationship works. So I've already typed in 7.00 here for reading 2, and so I'm going to go ahead and hit keep here. The voltage reading, as I can see from the top right, is stabilized at about 1.63, 1.64 volts. Once I hit keep here, I can hit OK, and the LabQuest will internally sort of build a calibration curve from these two points and assume that they're connected through a line to build the calibration curve. And notice that now the pH reading is stabilized at 7. A good check to make sure that you've done the calibration correctly, that doesn't take much time, is to come out of the pH 7 buffer, wash off a little bit, and then go right back into the pH 4 buffer. And obviously the pH here should be about 4.0. And notice the time it's taking to settle down to 4.0. This emphasizes the idea that the pH electrode takes a little bit of time to stabilize.